Welcome, my dear learners, for Mathematics Class 7, Area Lesson 3. Area of combined shapes and borders. Let us begin by combined shapes. Combined shapes meaning more than two or more than one shape put it together and then you get its area. In simple, identify the different shapes in one figure, do the area of respective shapes and then you add. For example, example number one. We have this figure. We have here, number one, we have a rectangle measuring 40 times 14. We have a semicircle measuring 14, because you are here the same, measuring 14 as the diameter. And then finally we have got the right angle, a right angle triangle. So therefore, number one, we begin by a rectangle. We begin by a rectangle. Length times width, which is 40 times 14, which will give you 560 meter square. 560 meters square. Then we go to figure number two. In the same figure, we have got a semicircle. We have got a semicircle. So semicircle area equals to a half, because of semi pi r squared. Therefore, it's a half times 22 over 7, pi is constant, times r. So here is 14, here is also 14, and 14 here will be the diameter. So divide by 2 to get 7 as the radius. So which means times 7 times 7. Upper one is equal to 154 divided by 2. 2 here 1, 2 here 7, because of 14, then 7. So it's equal to 77 meter square as the area of the second figure. Then apart from that, we have got the right angle triangle. Number 3, we have got the right angle triangle, right angle triangle, which is this one. We have got here is 40, so here is also 40. So E 40 meters will be the hypotenuse, and then we have got the height as 24, and then we don't have the base. We don't have the base. And remember, area of a right angle triangle is a half multiplied by base multiplied by height. A half base times height. So we are going to look for the base if we multiply. Remember, we have the hypotenuse, we have got the height, and then we don't have the base. So it is c squared minus a squared is equal to b squared, getting the base. So therefore, 40 squared minus 24 squared. 40 squared minus 24 squared. 40 squared is 1600, or rather 1600. Take away 24 squared is 576. Then when you take away, you'll get 1024. After there, you get the square root of your answer there, which will give you what? Which will give you that 2 meters. So that 2 becomes our height, our base here, that 2 meters. Then from there, you can get your area as a half times our base times our height as 24. 2 here 1, 2 here is 16. So you get 24 times 16, that is 24, carry 1, that is 12, 13, 4, 2, 4, 7, 3. So it's equal to 374 meter square as the area of a right angle triangle. So we have got 560 here, a rectangle. We have got 77 here, a semicircle, and then we have got 374, a right angle triangle. So therefore we add. So you take 560 plus 77 plus 374. 11 carry 1, 21. 21 carry 2, then 10. That is 710 meter square. So equals to 1011 meter square as the area of that combined cell. Example number 2. We have got this figure A and figure B. When you look very well, figure A represents right angle trapezium, and then figure B represents a semicircle. Therefore, it will be a half H into A plus B, that is area of a trapezium, plus a half pi r squared, which is the area of a right angle triangle. So therefore, it will be a half times height of that is 8 meters into 20 plus 32, plus 32. Then that is the area of a trapezium. You go to area of a semicircle, it has a 14 as a diameter, so therefore radius will be 7, which is a half times 22 over 7 times 7 times 7. So a half times 8 times 52, the sum. Upper 1, upper 4. When multiply, you'll get 208 meter square, that's the trapezium. Then we go to semicircle, upper 1, upper 1. So when you multiply, you get 77 meter square. So therefore we add. You add here 77, 5, carry 1, 8, 2. So the answer is 285 meter square as the area of that combined figure. The last one is these are two right angle triangles. We have A, B, C. Then we have A, C, D. Then we have A, B, D. So we are going to get the area. Sometimes they ask to get the area of either A, B, C or A, C, D or whichever. Now, but let us look each step. Let us begin by area of A, B, C. Area of A, B, C. A, B, C. We have got a hypotenuse here. We have got the height here, but we don't have the base. So right, first of all, we get the base first. So therefore, base, it is C squared minus A squared is equal to B squared, getting the base. So it is 30, 30 squared minus 18 squared, which will give you B squared. It is 900 minus 324, it will give you 576. Then when you get the square root, give you 24 centimeters. So our base here, we have got 24. So therefore the area of ABC is, area of ABC is ABC equals to a half times base 24 times height 18. 112. So when you multiply 12 and 18, you'll get 6, 3, 8, 1, 6, 1, 2. So equals to 216 centimeter square. So this one you have got 216 centimeter square. Then we go to A, B, D. A, B, D equals to a half times the base of A, B, D will be 24 plus 6, which is 30. The height remains the same, 18. 2 here 1, 2 here 9. When you multiply, you get 270 centimeter square. And then we have ACD. ACD is not a right angle triangle because it doesn't have a special angle. So therefore, if you want to get ACD, you just get, take ABD, the area of ABD minus the area of ABC. That means 270 centimeters squared minus 216 centimeters squared, which will give you, you take 270 minus 216, 10, 4, 6, give you 5. It give you 54 centimeter squared. As simple as that. We are finished with the combined shapes. The area of borders meaning getting the area of the shaded part. We have got example A here. Two rectangles, one the outer one and the inner one, and then separated by a margin of 2 centimeters each. Sometimes they call it, this one is a photo frame, then the outer one is a, the outer is a frame, and then this one is a photo. So they have asked you to get the area of the shaded part. Number one, first of all, you need to get the measurement of the inner rectangle. So let us get the length of the inner rectangle. You will take 2 plus 2, this margin. Remember, I'm dealing with the length, this one. 2 plus 2 equals to 4. Then you take that 4, you minus from the outer length. I will repeat. The inner length, 2 plus 2 is 4. You minus that 4 from that 4, the outer length, you will get 30 centimeter. Then the inner width, you will take 2 plus 2 equals to 4. Then you minus from the outer width, that is 20 minus 4, here is 16 centimeters. Then from there, you can get the area of the outer, the area of the inner, then you subtract. So the area of the outer area, A, is equal to 34 times 20, which will give you 680 centimeters square. 680 centimeters square outer. Area of the inner, area 2, it is 30 times 16, which will give you 480 centimeters square. So therefore, the area of the shaded part, which is area 3, area of the shaded part, this one, you will take 680 centimeters square, take away 480 centimeters square, which will give you 200 centimeters square as the area of the shaded part. Sometimes we have got the inner measurements, but at times you might not be given the outer one. How do you get the outer one now? You take the opposite, because the, you will take the length, now we have to get the length of the outer. Take 2 plus 2, which is 4, then you add to the length of the inner, 4 plus 30, you still get that 4 centimeter. And then the width of the outer, you take 2 plus 2, which is 4, then you add 4 to 16, then you get the length, the width of the outer, which will be the same. As simple as that. Now, example B, we are going to look at, this is the area of that shaded part. Here is a circle, and then enclosed in a square. So first of all, you will get the area of a square, which is 14 by 14, side times side, or side squared, which is 14 squared, will give you 196 centimeter square. Then you get the area of a circle, and then this line is the same as this line, 14 centimeter, which represents the diameter of that circle. So if 14 is the diameter, then the radius of that circle will be 7, half of the diameter. So area of a circle is equal to pi r squared, which is 22 over 7 times 7 times 7, you'll get 154 centimeter square. So the shaded area, you you take area of a square, 196 centimeter square, you minus area of a circle, 154 centimeter square, then you will get 42 centimeter square as the area of the shaded part. But sometimes they might shade only one. They might shade three. So how do you get the area of the shaded part? Three of them. Maybe you have not been given this one. Only three. You will do the same, but when you get 42, you realize that only three are shaded out of four. So just say 3/4 × 42, the one you have got here. 2 here, 2 here, 21. When you multiply, it's equal to 63/2, which will give you 21.5 centimeters as the area 21. Sorry, 31. 1.5 centimeter. But if they shade, if you got only two shaded, then it will be 2/4 × 42, which will give you 2 here, 2 here, 1 here, 1 here, 21, which will give you 21 centimeter. But if you get it's only one shaded, then it will be 1/4 × 42, which is 2/4. So it's equal to 10.5 if only one is shaded. Lastly, we have this one, the two circles, the outer circle and the inner circle, and then we get the area of the shaded part. So this 7 represents 7 centimeter, represents the radius of the inner circle, and then this 14 represents the radius of the outer circle. So first of all, we get the area of the outer circle, area 1, pi r squared, which is 22/7 × 14, 7/2, which is 44/14, which will give you 616 centimeter square. Then area of the outer circle, area 2, of the inner mean, 22/7 × 7 × 7, you will get 154 centimeter square. Then shaded area, you take 616 minus 154, it is 2, 11, 6, then 4 equals to 462 centimeter square as your area, the shaded part. Thank you very much.